Hi everyone, this is Joanne, and today I'd like to recommend to you four books, one I'm re-recommending, on the topic of chemistry. And all of these books would be great whether you're a high school student just being introduced to chemistry, a college student who has to study it a little more for their degree, whether it's engineering, biology, physics, chemistry, or if you're just a curious adult who wants to brush up on their chemistry by listening to really wonderful, engaging stories. So the first book I'm going to re-recommend is Teo Gray's wonderful picture book called The Elements, A Visual Exploration of Every Known Atom in the Universe. And of course, this is a lovely book that you can explore through the images in here. But I also want to mention that he has an iPad app version out there for you to check out. Of course, it'd be a little more interactive than a book. So go ahead and check that out if you haven't already. The next book I'd like to recommend is one that talks about the periodic table of the elements. And of course, it's not the first book written about the periodic table of the elements, and certainly will not be the last, but it's definitely one of the more charming and engaging books that I've read on the topic. And the book is filled with wonderful anecdotes about almost every single element. So this book is by Sam Kean, and it's called The Disappearing Spoon and Other True Tales of Madness, Love, and the History of the World from the Periodic Table of the Elements. And I found myself very intrigued with how the author put together the groups of elements. So he didn't just start at hydrogen and move his way through the periodic table, and he didn't merely just lump them together in some of the more conventional ways. And through his book, he explored biology and medicine, he explored technology, he explored the history of science, and also how scientists have done their work and how that has changed over the years. And neither did this book start at the very beginning and move all the way in a normal timeline. So I felt like the way he mixed it up kept it very interesting and very engaging. The next book I want to recommend is a book that I read about 4 or 5 years ago. It came out in 2003, but I definitely recalled enjoying the book, so I thought I'd give it a recommendation here. And it's a book called Napoleon's Buttons, rather, How 17 Molecules Changed the World, or Changed History, I'm sorry, by Penny Le Couteur and Jay Burreson. And of course, this talks about Napoleon's buttons being made of tin. And tin doesn't hold up very well under extreme cold. It actually changes its structure a little bit, and the buttons crumble. And so there's that assumption that because the buttons fell apart, their clothing was failing, and they were unable to survive the cold weather, and this affected the outcome of the wars. Now, this is just a minor story within this book. So this book talks about molecules like citric acid. It talks about dyes, and it talks about morphine, nicotine, caffeine. It talks about all of these various molecules that have been important in history. Salt and nitrocellulose, which we know as gun cotton. So I enjoyed this book. It's very, very good on the chemistry part. I definitely have to say that, and we do have wonderful drawings of molecules and reactions, and I think it could be a very useful addendum to almost any chemistry class, basic chemistry class. The history is less well integrated, but I felt like it was definitely a helpful thing to have in a book like this. So the third book I'd like to recommend is about very big molecules that we call polymers, where we've taken small molecules and they've joined together to form a very large molecule. The polymers occur in nature, such as in proteins and DNA and RNA, and those assemble spontaneously. We have also made, as human beings and researchers, very, very large molecules by putting molecules together. So polyethylene, nylon, for instance, these are polymers that most of us are aware of. But nanotubes are also examples of polymers. So this book is called Giant Molecules, From Nylon to Nanotubes by Walter Gratzer, right? And this is far from just being a material science book or a polymer book. I really enjoyed the stories of how various polymers have come to be and have affected our lives. You know, how has polyethylene changed our life? Isn't it great that shampoo is no longer in glass bottles and is in plastic bottles now? But what I really, really liked about this book that the other two books did not do was this book also looked forward to the future of polymers. What new materials might we be making? How might we be able to use DNA to act as a giant storage system? So how can we harness the power of molecules to store information and to change our lives even further? I enjoyed all three of these books, and I highly recommend all three of them, depending on what your purpose is in learning more chemistry. So go ahead and pick up one of these books and enjoy. Thanks for listening. Bye.